She's not hiding it. The community knows. Everybody knows. That's that woman again. And she has come to her concubine. Everybody knows. And the Osea is telling us. You know what you are crying? You know where there's no peace? You know where you're sick? You know why you're pressed? Osea tells us, I'll tell you the reason. The reason for horrible suffering. It comes to chapter 7. As it comes to chapter 7, it tells us in verse 2. It says, here is what we suffer. He said, they considered not in their heart that I remember all their wickedness. They consider not in their heart that I know their wickedness. Look up here. They say, what have I done? This is how my heart is. I didn't see anybody that has bush should not eat. I didn't see anybody that has a husband or wife should not have children. This is how my heart is. I don't know why I'm suffering. Osea said, you don't know. Why are we pretending? Why are we deceiving ourselves? You don't know your transgression.
So
you don't know all I've seen and come short of the glory of God. You don't say, you tell me you don't know that we tell lies. We get angry. We fight on the street. We fight in the bus. We fight everywhere. You want to tell me that you're an angel? Now, Osea said, if you will be humble and you will seek the face of the Lord tonight, you will come out of that suffering. I welcome you into healing. I welcome you into forgiveness. I welcome you to restoration. I welcome you to the kingdom of God tonight. Suffering will come to an end. Your sorrow will come to an end. Your sickness will come to an end. Osea tells us something. He said, this is terrible. Look at chapter 8. Chapter 8, I'm reading from verse 3. It says in verse 3, Israel has cast off the sin that is good. His enemy shall pursue him. Israel has cast off the sin that is good. God wanted Israel to be in the land of promise. There's a land of plenty. There's a land of power. There's a land of authority. There's a land of prosperity. And he called them. And he said, I'll make you the head and not the tail. He wanted to give them something. And then he said, but I give you my law. I give you my word. And Israel got that and threw that away. Israel has cast off the sin that is good.
Israel, it is there.
Have you noticed how many churches are in our villages and how many churches are in our localities and local government areas? All those churches, they have cast away the Bible. They cast away the word of God. They cast away the doctrine of Christ. They cast away repentance. Israel has cast off and cast away the sin that is good.
Israel, it is there.
That's what you find in the various churches today. I come to church, witches are pursuing me. I come to church, they press me down in the bed at night. I come to church, nothing I do prospers.
Mo lo si sosi n olu aluyo.
I come to church, I never pass exam.
Mo lo si sosi n osiyegenu
dawo. I come to church and there's no good coming in my life.
Mo lo si sosi sugba orere
ko daye bi Israel, Israel has cast off the thing that is good.
O do fani pe se ti gbe orere sonu.
And the enemy shall pursue him.
Ota yo le pare.
Look at verse 12. And see the problem here. I have written to him the great things of my law, but they were counted as a strange thing. He wanted to draw them near. He says, I am your savior. The more Christ is drawing near them, the more they are drawing back. I have reached unto them. I have spoken unto them. I have beckoned unto them. I have reached unto them the great things of my Lord. But
they
count that as a strange thing. And Hosea said, that's our problem. Hosea said, that's why we're suffering. Hosea said, that's why we get into this horrible problem. But tonight, are you ready? I said, are you ready? Tonight, you're coming out of that dungeon. The power of God will come in your life. And there is a bulldozer coming. All your mountains will vanish away. Because Hosea tells us, you can return. You can return. You can return. And Hosea is pleading with you. And I am pleading with you. And the Spirit of God is pleading with you. Return. Return. See all the ways of God. See all the things you have done. And they have not profited us. And so he tells us over and over and over again.
It
says, if you return, miracles are waiting for you. At the feet of Christ, in the presence of Christ, with the promise of Christ, tonight, the miracle of salvation. Am I talking to somebody there tonight? The miracle of restoration. Am I talking to somebody there tonight? The miracle of signs and wonders. The miracle of showers of blessings. Return. I will return. I said I will return. Say it for yourself, I will return. Hosea chapter 2. Hosea chapter 2. Look at verse 7. She shall follow after her lovers.
Or
she shall not overtake them. You understand that?
Say here.
She shall run after her lovers. Thinking, my lovers will solve my problem. That man will solve my problem. That woman will solve my problem. Manager will solve my problem. Director will solve my problem. MD will solve my problem. So and so will solve my problem. Uncle will solve my problem. And they be running away from you. Once you knock at the door, and then you say, go ask who is that? And then you say, who is that? I'm so and so. Who are you looking for? Uncle. And our problem. Okay, hold on there. Let me check up. Who is it? Madam so and so. Please go and tell her I am not in the office. And then they come back. He is not around. Leave a message. We will tell you when he comes. All those people you think will help you. There be a barrier between you and them. She is a beggar. He is a beggar. And he thinks I'm the one to be paying the school fees for our children. I'm the one to be paying her rent. I'm the one to be doing this and that for her. But you've been searching for them, they've not solved the problem. There is somebody who's always at home. His name is Jesus. He never tells an angel, go and tell her I'm not around. Jesus is here tonight. Your doctor is here tonight. The great physician is here tonight. He's always at home. He's always at home. He will forgive your sins. He will cancel the curse. He will break your yoke. He will destroy the works of the devil. Look at that verse 7 again. She shall follow her Lord. But she shall not overtake them. She shall seek them, but she shall not find them. Then shall she say, I will go and return to my first husband. I will go and return to the bridegroom. I will go and return to Jesus Christ. I will go and return to the lover of my soul. But then was it better with me than now? Coming to Jesus will give you the better life. All those of us who have been with the Lord, we know it's better to be with the Lord. He answers our prayer. He wipes away our tears. He silences the devil. He crushes the hand of the enemy. He gives us righteousness. He has got to prepare a place for us in heaven. I will return to the bridegroom. I will return to the love of my soul. But then was it better with me than now?
Chapter 3 verse 5.
Afterward shall the children of Israel return. That's the secret of blessing. That's the secret of miracle. Afterward shall the children of Israel return and seek the Lord their God. And seek the Lord their God. The latter part says that the goodness is goodness in the latter days. That blessing is coming to you tonight. Look at chapter 5 verse 15. I will go and return to my place. Till they acknowledge their offense and seek my face. In their affliction they will seek me early. Have you not suffered enough? Have you not cried enough? Have you not been hungry enough? Have you not been thirsty enough? Have you not run around enough? Enough is enough. Tonight is the night of your miracle. Tonight is the night of breaking the yoke. Cry no more. Be sorrowful no more. Because if you will return, the blessing of God will come to you tonight. If you will return, the power of the Lord will break every yoke in your life tonight. Somebody there says, I will return. Somebody there say, I will return. In fact, you're saying, it's not only yourself alone. The husband and the wife will return tonight. The parents and the children will return tonight. Members who have gone astray. Church members who have gone away. You are there tonight. Let the prodigal son, let the prodigal daughter, the Lord is waiting for you. What will you suffer? The child of a king, the king of kings is your father. father. The Lord of lords is your father. And he's waiting for you. He's not going to chastise you. He's not going to punish you. He said, return. That's why they said in chapter 6, verse 1. And let us return unto the Lord. Come and let us return unto the Lord. He said, not just me. He said, as for me, I return. As for me, I answer the call. As for me, I come back today. As for me, I seek the Lord Jesus Christ. And he's calling upon his wife. Come, my wife. You know, I came to marry you. Because I was in a hurry. I backslid because of you. And now we are here today. We're going together to Jesus tonight. Come and let us return. My boy, there you are telling that girl. We've been messing up together. And we're suffering. The last exam, a medical exam we did, they said, we have this, we're suffering.
I
said, tonight I'm going back to Jesus. I want forgiveness. I want salvation. I want cleansing. I want healing. And you are telling that girl, I'm going to Christ. I'm going to the Savior. Come and let us return. You're telling your friend over there. You're telling your neighbors over there. We're returning to the Lord tonight. We're returning with humble hearts. My people who are called by my name will humble themselves and seek my face and pray and turn from their wicked ways. I will hear from heaven. I will forgive their sins. And praise the Lord, he will heal our land. I said he will heal our land. Come and let us return unto the Lord. For he has turned and he will heal us. He has smitten and he will bind us up. Restoration is coming to you tonight. Renewal is coming to you tonight. Revival is coming to you tonight. How does it come? Hosea chapter 14. He said, O Israel, return unto the Lord thy God. Satan did not create you. Return unto the Lord thy God. That secret cult did not bring you to the world. Return unto the Lord thy God. All the shrine you make your second home, that did not bring you to the world. He says, return unto the Lord thy God. But thou hast fallen by thine iniquity. Take with you words as you come. And turn to the Lord and say unto him. He's even making it simple for us. He teaches us how to pray. He tells us what to tell the Lord when we return. He says, we shall say to the Lord, take away all iniquity. And receive us graciously. He says we should tell him what we need is grace. What we need is mercy. Receive us graciously. And so will we render the calf of our lips. And then it says, Asher shall not save us. Idols will not save us. Evil spirit will not save us. And the water spirit will not save us. Idols and images will not save us. We will not take upon, we will not ride upon horses. Neither we will say to any more to the work of our hands, ye are our God.